it's a music theme, obviously, and we decided to go like the concert route because I guess music is kind of like concerts and stuff. So we have a lead singer on the front, he's holding a guitar, and then we have like the fans going along the side with like the laser lights coming down, like the whole concert theme. And then we have a ticket stub on the back. I just kind of thought like old school concerts from like back in the 80s, how they'd wear their denim jackets and they'd have like their concert pins and stuff from all the concerts they've gone to. So we decided to take a collar from a denim jacket and put it around the outside of the shoe. And then we needed to tie in kind of like more of the jacket. So we added it where the shoelaces would have gone.
The most challenging part, in my opinion, was probably the detail work, because that's what I was like focusing on, were the little details that maybe weren't seen by everybody else, but like I had to see myself. I used like watercolor to work with the people. That was cool because I haven't used much watercolor in my like art experience, but the way it works, it adds a different like level to the people, to like their clothing and things, have a nice interesting like texture. That it just creates itself.
Decided to do for art shoes a stained glass design because we thought it would be really cool and different.
This one is a camera with a reflection in the lens of a valley in a sunset.
And then this one is a paint palette and it has different colors. And then it has a paint tube, and then we have a paintbrush.
At our school, our art students have designed around like 15 or more stained glass windows around the school. And so it's a kind of connecting our school to the shoes.
Shoes, and we're from Omaha, Nebraska, so we kind of went back to like the Omaha tribe, just kind of going back to like the roots, and I did a lot of research on like the designs, and so on Omaha Moccasins they'd have a dragonfly on the center, so we do have a dragonfly that is being placed on the front of the shoes. I did the landscape on the sides of the shoe, and I'm including a river because water is a big part of the name of Omaha and Nebraska.
I did the pattern on the bottom of the shoe, and it just kind of represents one of the patterns that the Omahans would use that represents like herbal plants.